Finally!
There you are!
I've been waiting for you.
It's been ages.
Yep.
Merry Christmas!
Merry Christmas!
I'm so glad you made it.
Yeah, you're welcome.
You look like you've been eating chicken.
It's obvious. It's Christmas.
Yeah, that's why it's late.
You've had turkey.
And goat meat.
Sweet salad.
And fried rice.
My God.
Anyway, we're glad you're here now, so you know how we do here, chicken.
Yeah.
Worship things
first. We enter into the house of God with worship and thanksgiving on our lips.
Yes.
And with our gestures. Let's go.
But wait, Dex.
How far?
I've got to tell them. They have an amazing cyber family.
Oh, that's true. Very engaging cyber community.
Exactly. Yeah. So you need to follow us on all our social media platforms.
Follow us on Facebook.
On Instagram.
Instagram. We're on YouTube as HOK Metro TV.
Yeah. And don't forget to follow our pastor at PJT Bakare on Instagram.
Yeah.
You can start by liking.
Like this video now.
And sharing it, because service is going to be amazing.
It's Christmas. Give. Share with people.
Yes, come on.
Invite them to come and enjoy what you're about to enjoy.
Yes.
Precious, let's go and worship.
Come on in.
Yeah, come on. Don't stop, don't stop. Yeah. Hey, 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 hey. Everybody don't stop. Come on. Come and see all.
Come and see all.
Come and see all.
Come and see.
Hallelujah. Look what the Lord has done.
Look what the Lord has done for me.
Let me hear you say.
Come and see all.
Come on, one time.
Come and see, oh,
come and see,
come and
look what the Lord has done.
The Lord has done. Come and see, oh,
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 The song.
I know the worship was fun.
It was like come and see.
Like it was amazing. Yeah. As in God has done so much through the year.
I mean, he's been
so good. Yeah, I'm a testimony.
I'm living in
victory. Of 2021. I know, right?
Yes. But Dex.
Yeah.
Did you think about it? Like birthing the savior of the world.
I know, right?
Yes, that's like.
Like you being the mother of.
The Savior.
Yeah, because this season we're celebrating Christ who was born.
Yes, the birth of Christ, the birth of the deliverer.
How the family were, how they experienced Him.
Exactly.
Yeah.
But Dex, did you know?
I actually think, right, there's a way this beautiful, amazing lady worshipped. There's a way she told the story.
Yeah, the way she told the story.
From the perspective of how Mary, the mother of Christ, you know, witnessing her child growing up, doing amazing things.
Yeah.
So I think we should share that story with you.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So here's worship with Mary. Did you know?
Our sons and daughters Did you know that your baby boy has come to me? You knew this child that you delivered would soon deliver you. Mary, did you know? Did you know that your baby boy would give sight to a blind man? Mary, did you know that your baby boy would save us? Oh, did you know that your baby boy has walked where angels run? When you kiss your little baby, you kiss the face of God. Mary, did you know? Yeah. Oh, Mary, did you know? Yeah. The blind will see, the deaf will hear, and the dead will live again. The lame will live, the deaf will hear, the praises of our God. Mary, did you know? Your baby boy, yeah. Mary, did you know? Yeah. Mary, did you know?
Did you know? Mary, did you know? But come to think of it, Mary wasn't the only one who gave. God also gave. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. Keyword, gave. Giving. Christmas is about giving, spreading joy and giving all you've got. That's why I'm going to surprise some people with some good gifts. Hi Dex, right. Merry Christmas!
Yes!
And thank of you. Course, Job, I've got something for you as well. Merry Christmas!
Thank you!
But the giving doesn't stop there. At House of Kings, we give lots of gifts. And I've got one specially for you. It's the gift of a drama that encompasses everything that Christmas is all about. And I hope you enjoy this gift I'm giving you.
Sweetheart, you've been unhappy since morning. Talk to your wife. What is the problem?
Madam, tell me, how can I be happy? What is there to make me happy? Tomorrow is Christmas. No new clothes for the children. No food in the house. No Christmas chicken. So why should I be happy?
But I've told you not to worry.
God will provide.
God will provide, God will provide. How and when? What will he provide? Now let me tell you, man. This house rent is expired. And landlord gave us today to vacate. You know that this is 1 year I lost my job. And as I'm talking to you now, you are very much aware that I have nothing. I can't even pay our bills.
I know, I understand. But God is too faithful to save us. We've been through a lot since this year. And we don't look like half of the things we've been through. We have every reason to be happy.
Happy?
Yes!
Every reason to be happy. What is here to make me happy?
Okay, see, I have 10,000 naira here with me. I'm serious. I have 10,000 naira here with me. Would you use that for Christmas?
10,000 naira, is it for children's clothes? 10,000 naira, is it for food or for Christmas ticket? What am I going to do with 10,000?
Manage.
Manage what? What are we managing?
Calm down.
Woman, this is Christmas Eve. I should be my love. Tell him I'm not coming.
Who is there coming? I'm coming.
Ah, Mrs. Wright.
How
are you?
Mrs.
Wright.
Just have to come. Yeah, why? Why are you not like an umbrella now?
See, calm down. Do you know this moment? I'm not in the right frame of mind for all of this. See, my son has been hospitalized for 2 days now.
Oh my.
2 days. The doctors will not touch him. They said I must make a deposit of 20,000 naira. And I'm not to your me. Absolutely nothing. You don't want to help me anywhere, please. You are my
I'm not the hero to talk of the last. See, as I'm talking to you now, one naira that. Spoiled, we don't even have a nice house. So, I'm sorry. Just look around. We don't have anything.
Mr. John, see, please get up. Like he said, we honestly don't have much. This is all we've got in this house right now.
You don't know where you are. You are saving it.
I know. Please. Just hurry.
Thank
you. Hurry. Well.
Wait. What did you just do?
But his son is dying.
What about us? What about tomorrow? What about Christmas again?
Listen, this is what Christmas is about. Giving and sharing.
Must we be the giver? Can't we receive?
Who's that again?
That love, see, it's coming to me. I travel.
Come in.
Hello, Madam Juliet. Are you okay, Mrs. Smythe? Hi. I'm actually not okay, that's the truth. What is going on? Since yesterday, my kids have not eaten anything. Please. Whatever you can find, I beg you, please, help me. I don't mind, anything, whatever it is, leftover food, just help me, please.
Okay, come and sit down.
No, just sit down.
Okay, but
help me, dog, please.
I'm coming.
Okay.
Please save my children, save my kids. I believe. Oh Lord, help me.
Madam Juliet, see, we also don't have enough food in this house, but I know this will go a long way.
Oh, more than enough. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Please don't cry. I know they are waiting
for you.
Thank you. I don't know how to pay you.
God bless you.
Thank you so much. Merry Christmas.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Easy now.
That rice you just gave up was the only food in this house. You could give us another one. What? Are you okay?
I know. I'm not being. I trust God. He will provide for us.
Sell me that offspring! God will provide! I shall give that everything you have in this house.
I know, but I can't help it. This is what Christmas is about. giving and sharing.
Why can't we receive? Must we give? Yes? You mean I'm not doing any of that? No. Who is that again? We have nothing left. Just go. Go! Go! Put down your face before.
Mr. Mike, Mrs. Mike, good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
How are you? How are you?
How are you? Landlord.
Your money. That is what we are just talking about. Is that what we are talking about? That's what we are just planning on how to pay you, but you know, you are a man and you understand it. Just give me 4 months, I'll pay you. Please.
Okay, how much is your house rent again?
Please.
800,000, sir.
800,000.
Okay, it's like you paid deposit. How much was your deposit?
I struggled to get 200,000.
Okay, that means I'm correct. This is the 2,000.
Yes,
sir. Please, sir.
I will pay you. I will pay you. I will hustle. Don't give me like 4 months. I will pay you. Please, I have this. I have this.
Yesterday in church, my pastor preached about the essence of Christmas, which is giving. So my wife and I decided to give you Christmas gift and decided to form your to give your house rent as a Christmas gift.
Oh,
that's why I'm turning this. Sorry, Father. I'll be offering you two right now. I just said let me do this before. And my regards to you.
Oh my god! Oh my god! Thank you, sir! Hey! Am I dreaming? Am I?
Wait! My house rent is paid and I have 200,000 to celebrate! Hey!
This is a dream! Okay. Somebody needs to wake me. You know, the scriptures say, see, is that. When the Lord
turned again, you can see me. We are like them that dream dreams. This is reality. Hey!
No!
Okay.
Thank you, Jesus! See that I told you God will provide!
We know.
Oh my God!
That's
bring money, bring money, bring money. I need to go to the market now.
God will provide.
God has provided me this money. I'm not joking.
Hope you enjoyed that beautiful play from the HOK Metro production team. Talking about giving, the miracle of giving. When you give, you would receive more, definitely. And Christmas is not just about giving. In this season, we listen to so many beautiful songs as you walk through your streets, as you go to visit your neighbors, you know, and one of my favorites was really, really done well by our very own Sound of Heaven Company. Guys, am I right?
Yes.
So here's the Sound of Heaven Company with Lift Up Your Voices and the Hallelujah Medley.
Now sing praises unto God
for all
the things that He has done, all for
up your voices now, sing praises unto God. For all the things that he has done, all glory unto him, he is the morning sun. Sing praises unto God, we lift our voices to God.
Is that what you're doing with your heart this evening? We lift our voices.
We lift our voices to God.
You've won for us.
For all of the things you have done.
For all of the things that you have done.
For all of the things
you have done.
You have done.
You have done.
For all of the things you have done.
Everybody, are you ready?
Salvation and glory.
so good, for the Lord.
For the Lord our God is mighty.
Yes, the Lord.
Yes, the Lord our God is omnipotent.
The Lord.
The Lord our God.
He
is wonderful.
Oh, ladies, praises.
I sure did enjoy that, and I hope you did too. Come on, you have to enjoy that. Look at that heavenly sound. Hallelujah. That is the sound of heaven, y'all. And the next one is from our very own PJT Bakare and the Sound of Heaven Company. This is a song that will definitely bless you. I'm very sure of that. It's titled, He is Not Just a Man. Jesus is not just a man, he's a king, he's a ruler, and he came to bring light to our world. So sure you want to hear this. He's not just a man. PJT and the Sound of Heaven Company. Enjoy.
The greatest gift to man from the Father, which changes all in ways we've never seen. Yet his first moment wearing a manger, yet soon every living thing will call him king. Yes, they will, though we didn't know it then. We soon will understand that his life would be the greatest gift to man. Whoa, 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 whoa. Not just a man,
he is not,
he is not just a baby, yeah. Oh, no, he is not just a lamb, but the lamb.
Man.
report who he is. The one who hung on the cross for you today. The one who hung on the cross for me. Who he is. He is not just a man. You say he is Lord. If you know he's Lord, come on, lift your voice and shout the victory. Amen.
So Dex.
Yeah.
You know, Jesus is not just a baby. He's not just king. Yeah. He's not just Lord. He's not just the Lamb or the Lion of Judah.
Yeah.
And he didn't just come to fulfill the will of God. He actually came in the volume of the books.
Exactly.
All that was written about
That's so true. Yeah. He came, he died for us. Everything he did was according to the scriptures, according to the volumes of the books. And our stories have been written.
Yeah.
Because God said that before he formed us, he knew us. Right. And then, I don't know if you've actually met Pastor Moses Ako. He sang this song,
The Volume of the Books.
It's so amazing.
Yeah.
I would like to share that with you.
Yeah. And you know what, Dex? Something has been on my mind.
Right.
I keep wondering when people say, which is greater, the birth or the death of
Jesus? I know, right? It's been a serious debate.
In fact, I'm even thinking right now, what is 25th December? Is it just about the birth of Christ?
Importance? Yeah. Hmm. Okay.
But then Pastor's gonna break that down for us.
Oh, wonderful! So
and
here's
at the end, you're going to answer for yourself.
Okay.
What Christmas should mean to you?
Yeah. So I'll share with you Pastor Moses Ako's The Volume of the Books.
And I'll share with you Pastor Deity Bakare's message on the significance and importance of Christmas.
Meranis te vegan doriasi, para sustis te hava. Just press in. Come on, begin to press in the spirit right now. Song says, I've come in the volume of the book. It was written about me to do your will, O God. Can I get my volume on my microphone? I've come in the volume of the book. It was written about you to do God's will, I will do your will, do your will, do your will, O God. I will do your will, do your will, do your will, O God. Let me hear you say, to do about how many of you know the song by now? Let me hear you say, oh yeah, yeah, in the volume of the book, it was to do your yeah. See. Yeah, see, check. I've come prophetically, apostolic, my marching order. The words you spoke from eternity past, you never stuttered. I've complained for the complaints of your sons and daughters. The love of Christ is my constraint, it's my life I offer. The library of heaven, the volume of the books. I feel perfection like seven, upon your face I look. Jesus, my perfect example, the sacrifice it took. The earth forever will tremble because the heavens shook. And as my hours pass, like in the hourglass, I stay reminded at your feet is where I bow at last. Is my timekeeper, the Father be the principal, and Jesus, the Godhead in our class. Well done is what you say to me. Well done, my servant, is what you be saying to me, Lord. It is finished, I say. Well done, my faithful servant, is what you saying to me, Lord.
I will do your will.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
Do your will, oh God.
Do your will.
Jesus, come on, all over the room. I will do your will. Oh, da, 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 da. And I will do your will.
I will do your will, oh God. Lift your hand and say that song to the Lord. Say, I will do your will no matter whatever comes my way. I have come to do your will. I will fulfill all that is written concerning me. As the Lord Jesus fulfilled all that was written about him, I will fulfill all that is written about me in Jesus' name. If you believe that prayer, shout the victory where you are. Come on. Amen, amen. You may be seated. God bless you, Sound of Heaven Company. While you take your seats, I want you to one more time help me celebrate these guys who put in so much work to make this carol a humongous success. The Sound of Heaven Company, y'all, help me celebrate. Amazing. So much work went into this carol, and we thank you for putting in so much work to make the praise of our King glorious. There's a great debate out there about which of these two events is more significant in history, either the birth of Jesus or his passion, his death, his burial, and his resurrection. And although I do not have the time to get into the nitty-gritties of that great theological conversation, let us know as a matter of fact that the relationship between the birth of Jesus and the death of Jesus is not a relationship that can be compared, because one is causality and the other is effect. He was born to die. And since he was born to die, it is impossible to talk about his death without his birth. And it is not enough to talk about his birth without talking about his death. He's the only one who was born to die. So we cannot compare his death with his birth, because in his birth is his death. Because that's why he was born. And in his death is the reason why he was born. So whether it is at his birth or at his death, both of them are one and the same thing, depending on which point in human history you are speaking from. And so since we celebrate his birth, we celebrate his death, his burial, and his resurrection, you will discover that history, which is the next historical conversation, we have the dates of his death, burial, and resurrection, and we can celebrate it with exactitude because we know exactly when on the calendar he was crucified and raised from the dead. But there is nothing in the records of history to tell us exactly when he was born. And there is a prophetic reason why God did not allow us to have the detail of the date of his birth, although we have the detail of the date of his death. Because as it is with Jesus, so it was with Moses. We knew when Moses was born, but nobody knew when Moses died. And Moses was the Old Testament replica, leadership replica of the Lord Jesus. When Moses died, God covered the dead and covered the grave and left no relic behind to help anybody know exactly when he died, where he died, when he was buried. God did the ceremony celestial. They only got to celebrate him at his birth. They never got to celebrate him at his death. And when Jesus will come, who will truly bring all of mankind out of slavery? Moses brought the Hebrew people out of slavery. But Jesus was going to come and bring all of mankind out of slavery into the liberty of God's marvelous light. The flip result was the case. In his time, we have no details about his birth, but we have all the details about his death. In fact, it is the biggest error to celebrate the birth of Jesus in December. And that's for very many reasons that we cannot get into right now because of time. God deliberately left it a mystery. The only clue we have into the detail of where in the calendar Jesus must have been born is the information we receive from scripture about the shepherds. The Bible says, while shepherds watched their sheep by night, they had an encounter. The host of angels appeared to them. If you know anything about the Middle Eastern shepherding system, you will understand that there is something unique about shepherds watching their sheep by night. Because in the very cold seasons, which is around now, between now and January and February, just like you have it here in the Harmattan, it gets very cold around this period there. No shepherd watches sheep by night because the night is too cold. Any sheep and shepherd awake in the night is going to die. So the only possible time on the calendar when shepherds could watch their sheep at night was not in the cold season, but in the warm season. Are you still there? Because when it's warm, it is too warm in the day for sheep to graze. Because it was a desert area. So the only opportunity sheep had to graze in the hot season was at night. Because at night, for the first time, it is cool enough for the shepherd to lead his sheep into the pasture. But when the cold season comes and the winter comes, there's too much snow in the night. The only opportunity for grazing will be in the day, when the sun may have melted some of the ice and it is possible to find some pasture for the sheep. So there is a complete departure from the actual time with our decision to celebrate his birth around now, because this is winter. And the reason why God gives us no details about the truth about his birth is because when he died for us. When he died as us. When he died as our example, the pattern son, the Paschal Lamb of God. We all look to the cross of his death, burial, and his resurrection as a date in history when the great exchange happened. But he keeps the record of his birth away from us, because when it comes to his birth, it is an experience that should happen as many times in the calendar as people give their lives to Christ. Every time somebody is born again, Jesus is born. Every time somebody surrenders their life to Christ, because in effect, what you do when you get saved is you don't give your life to Christ, you have no life. You're dead in sin. You couldn't have given your dead life to Christ. He doesn't keep dead things. What you did when you got saved was you received his life. It was his life he gave to you. You had no life to give him. You had nothing to present to him. You came just as you are, dead in your sin. And when his life bumped into yours, there was an impartation of righteousness. You received him. What happened in the manger happened in your heart. And so for you, your date for the birth of Jesus is the day you gave your life to Christ. It's the true date for you. So if you haven't given your life to Jesus Christ, you have no reference point for Christmas. You have no business with Christmas, because Christmas does not yet have a date in your life. It is an experience that has no date. And if it is not dated, it is not real. So the date is kept away so that it is your accepting of Jesus Christ into your life that gives it date. And when you give it date, it gives you meaning. It gives your life a meaning. So the date of Christmas is not December 25th. No! 1,000 times no! History even lets us know it's wrong. There was some manipulation from the Roman Catholic Church, we can't get into all of that, that led to our decision to celebrate it at the end of the year. It has no truth in it about the exact time. The exact time only comes to life the day that you stood on your feet and said, Jesus, I'm coming in the volumes of the book. It is written about me to do your will. Ah, and what happened to Jesus happened to you when he stepped down from eternity, took off all the glories that he had with the Father. He took it off like a garment, took it off himself, and then he stepped down from glory and he stepped down into time. And because he came naked, he needed another jacket with which, an earth suit with which to make himself legitimate. It's the glory he shared with the Father that makes him heaven's prince, heaven's darling boy. And so when he stepped down from heaven and stepped into time, he, looking for a garment, since he left his heavenly garment with the Father, that was what he was crying for when he knelt before the Father and said, glorify me with the glory that I had with you. And God said, I've glorified it, and I will yet glorify. He had a glory that he had with the Father that he was craving for. The earth was cold. He had never been without his glory cloth. So when he stepped down into time, he looked in for a wardrobe, somewhere where he could get a suit with which to enter this world. And he found a wardrobe in the womb of a woman called Mary. And he stepped into her womb and put on clothes from her womb. And when angels saw that God immortal picks up a garment from the womb of a woman like you would a dressing room, they said she's highly favored because God has chosen her DNA to produce the flesh with which he does the will. And that grand entry into the earth is replicated in your heart. We just sang a beautiful song. I come in the volume of the book. It is written about me to do thy will, O God. That scripture, oh, this is not a teaching service. It's a carol service. That scripture is the technology for incarnation. It's teaching you how the Word became the Christ. Before he was Jesus, he was the Word. We never knew the Christ. 1 Thessalonians 3:16 says, great is the mystery of godliness. And one of the things he lists as the mysteries of godliness there, he says that he was seen of angels. Seen of angels, which means angels never saw God until Jesus was born. Take it to the bank. Because the one they worshipped dwelt in light inapproachable. And it will be impossible to truly put a figure, a shape on the one they worship. Every attempt caused them to fall on their feet. They really cannot take it all that he is. And so the reason they were excited in heaven and the reason they came into the earth and started an orchestra and a choir that the shepherds saw was because for the first time, God was seen by angels. That shape was Jesus. He was manifest in the flesh, justified in the spirit, seen of angels, preached among the Gentiles, received into glory. What great mystery. What great mystery. And so I was saying that is the technology of incarnation, because what that means is that what the second person of the Godhead did in order to be born through the womb of the woman Mary was that he traveled through human history. Don't forget, he is the Word. So everywhere any prophet ever prophesied the coming of the Messiah, that was Jesus in a suspension waiting for the fullness of time. The Bible declares that when the fullness of time came, God sent forth his son into the world. So time was coming, but it had to get to a crescendo. It had to get to the fullness. What was moving in time? It was every word. Every time Isaiah got up and spoke to Israel and began to release messianic prophecies, that was Jesus gathering flesh. Every time David took his harp and played a tune and it became messianic and prophesied the coming of the Word to save God's people from their sin, he was making a body thou had prepared, a body thou had prepared for me, he says. So what the second person of the Godhead did was he traveled through human history and picked on every prophecy, every word, because he is the, talk to me, he's the what? He picked up every word ever prophesied about his coming. And when he put it all together, he entered with that prophetic force into the woman's womb. That's why when she asked, how shall these things be, seeing that I have not fulfilled the masculine requisite protocol to have a child. And he's saying, and the angel said to him, to her, I beg your pardon, the Spirit of the Lord will overshadow you. The power of the highest will cover you. And then what will be found in you? The Holy Child will be found in you. will be Jesus Christ. So that was the processional hymn as he came. I come, but my access route to this world is first the volumes of the book. It's not the womb of the woman. I come, but I come by a transport called the volumes of the book. I come in the volumes. I enter the book. I pick up everything that is about me. And then when they are all complete, then I can come into this world and do your will. That's why Jesus will never do a thing except that it may be fulfilled that was prophesied. Except that it was that it may be fulfilled which was said by the prophet. He will never take a step except that it may be fulfilled which was spoken by the prophet. Because what made him up was everything that was written about him. This is the mystery of the new birth. The moment you get born again, everything written and spoken from the mouth of God about you enters you. Before you get saved, you are without purpose. Your life has no meaning. You have no life. The life of God has not come to you. But every question of purpose and identity and the future catches up with you the moment you say yes to Jesus. Because as he came through the volumes of the book, gathering back every prophecy so he can make his entrance. When he goes into the womb of the woman and puts flesh, flesh came on the word. Because the Bible says the word became. So it was all of flesh now wearing the word. It was all of the word, beg your pardon, now wearing flesh. Which word? Every prophesied word about him. So when he showed up, he was living a prophesied life. This is the joy of the new birth. That your life is not ordinary. That you can never be confused as a born-again Christian. Somebody just needs to tell you that within you is resident every answer of wisdom and power. The Bible says that the Jews, they seek a sign. The Gentiles seek wisdom. But we preach Christ crucified. He may come across like a stumbling block, but he is the wisdom and the power of God. Did you remember, finally, thinking about the fact that all the answers of your life are inside you? All the answers. The prosperity you need is not outside of you. It's inside of you. It's inside of you. Oh dear. How can I tell you this more clearly? That there is nothing you need for life and godliness that is on your outside. There's nothing. Everything is resident in you. Do you remember that when Jesus was born, the first thing he did was answered mankind? That's what happens at your new birth. You show up at your new birth with answers. Suddenly, the question of purpose is answered. The question of identity is answered. That's what that joy you feel when you get saved. How many of you have felt that thing called the joy of salvation? It is a river that carries with it all the things you need for life and godliness. It's a river. You call it the river of joy. River is not river except it has fish. It's bringing things into your life. That river is not, if it didn't have life within it, it would be a dam. If it didn't have life within it, it would be irrigation. It is a river because its courses is bringing life into you. Have you noticed? Do you remember that when Jesus was born, two particular powerful things happened? The first one was the Bible says that the Magi, the wise men from the east, what did they do? They saw the star. So he left a star in heaven, which is a sign. Somebody say a sign. Oh dear, they're not here. I'm not in the right congregation. Say it with me. Say a sign. So when Jesus is born, because he is the answer, he leaves a sign. He leaves a sign. And the Bible says when they saw the star, they followed it from the east. And when they had a conversation with Herod, the star appeared again and led them to where the child was and stood over the house where the child was. And the Bible says they rejoiced. They sang with exceeding great joy. But do you also remember that shepherds who were watching their flock by night, the Bible says that angels singing in glory appeared to them and gave them wisdom. And said, now, in so and so city, there is born to you this day Jesus Christ, the Lord. That day Jesus was born, the Gentiles, represented by the wise men from the east, from hidden lands, that day they received their sign. That day Jesus was born, the Jews, Jewish men keeping watch over their flock, that day they received wisdom. Wisdom from the celestial realm. Angels appeared to them and gave them revelation about the Christ that they could not otherwise have known, because there was no Google, there was no hashtag, there was no search engine, and it was already night. There was no other way they could have gotten that information other than by the wisdom of God. And so I want to pray for everyone who's born again, that on the strength of the things I've shared to you tonight, is there any gray area in your life where you're asking God for clarity, that clarity will come? They didn't hear me. Because I have just shown you it is your birthright. And I want to pray for you if you have not received Jesus as your Lord and your King, that your life has no meaning. Your life has not started. Your life has not taken off. Don't forget, when he was born, they said two things happened. Unto us a child is born. Unto us a son. All about him was not the child that was born. A son was not born, it was given. One was biology, the other one was a gift from the Spirit. Two of those things happened at the same time. I hope you know it was not the son that was given that ran to Egypt for fear of Pharaoh. It was the child that was born. The son that was given. Oh, dear. That's a conversation for another day. That's it. Matthew 2, verse 2. Where is he that is born king? Where is he that is born king of the Jews? Stand to your feet. Where is he that is born king of the Jews? Where is he that is born king? Where is he that is born king of the Jews? For we have seen his star in the east. I'm going to ask God to answer every question on your life, solve every puzzle in your life, answer every question, solve every riddle, give you answers, give you a sign, give you wonders, give you wisdom in areas of your life where you are yet to see the manifestation of he who is born king. Are there believers here? Just pray. 30 seconds. This is the beauty of Christmas. It is that what happened that day in the manger has happened in your spirit. Therefore, there is a sign, there is a wonder, there are answers now. It's written about me. Do your will, God. If you're under the sound of my voice, you have not received meaning. You may have made money, but you still have no meaning. You may be envied by others, but deep in your heart, you know that life has been a struggle. You haven't said, Jesus, come and be born in my heart like you were born on that in that manger in swaddling clothes. Let the experience of 2,000 plus years ago happen in my heart. You haven't made that prayer. I want to pray for you. All you have to do is raise your hand where you are. Every boy, girl, man, woman, old and young. Don't miss this opportunity to receive Jesus as your King and as your Savior and as your friend. Allow him to be born in your heart so that the things that I have shared today will become not just a story for the history books, but the experience of your heart. Say, Jesus, I come to you. I believe you are the Son of God, born of a virgin. Lived a sinless life, dying for my sin, and God raised you up from the dead on the Thursday. Now I bring myself to you, and I receive your life. Touch me, change me, fix me, justify me, choose me, glorify me. Do a quick walk in my heart. Let this Christmas put a date to the history story. Let it become personal to me, God. I receive grace to live the life of Christ every day of my life. Therefore, I declare I'm forgiven. I am justified. I am loved. I am beloved. I am accepted. I am a child of God. Today is the beginning of days in my life. For lo, I come in the volumes of the book. Yes, it is written of me to do your will. Thank you, Father, in the name of Jesus. To do your will, do your will. I'll come in the volumes of the book. Do your will, oh God. I'll come in the volumes of the book. Hey, yeah. Do your will. I will do your will. Your will. Will do your will, oh God. Yeah, I will do. I will do your will. I will do your will, oh God. Thank you, Father. Put your hands together and celebrate the one who is born King. He is Lord. He is Lord. Hallelujah. Amen.
That was insightful. That was a new revelation to Christmas. You know, just like Pastor, if you have not received purpose, you have not received meaning. The revelation of 2,000 years ago has not materialized in your heart. And if you want to allow Jesus to be born in your heart, with your whole heart, say these prayers after me. Say, Jesus, I come to you. I believe that you were born of a virgin, that you died a sinless man, and you rose up on the third day. Now, I bring myself, and I receive life, your life. Fix me, justify me, touch me, choose me, do a quick work in my life. Let this Christmas be a date in the history of my story.
If you said this prayer, congratulations. Christmas has come alive in you and you are saved. We would love to connect with you. So please kindly send us an email to hokmetro@gmail.com. Right now, let's get into the mood the angels are in. Hark, the herald angels sing.
Thank you.
Merry Christmas!